And welcome to Couples in Christ, a P-Square production devotional. I'm Pastor Tim.
I'm Patty.
And this is, as I already mentioned, Couples in Christ. What are we reading from the Bible today?
We're going to look at the book of 1 John. We'll go to chapter 4, and we're going to read verses 11 through 12. My dear friends, if God loved us like this, we certainly ought to love each other. No one has seen God, ever. But if we love one another, God dwells deeply within us, and his love becomes complete in us. Perfect love.
Awesome. So what are we going to talk about today?
What are we going to talk about?
Perfect love?
Kind of. We're going to talk about how to make our love more perfect. We're going to talk about the actual love languages from Gary Chapman's book.
I know it's backwards. Sorry.
We'll leave a link where you can buy this on Amazon at the bottom. And then also, you could get it from your public library. If you want to be able to write in it, you know, you can get it. Many church libraries may have it. I think the St. Paul's Church Library has it.
I think they do.
Yep. If you're local and you want to buy it, give us a shout out.
Yeah. And so we're going to go over briefly what the five love languages are. The first one is words of affirmation. That's using positive words to affirm your love for your spouse.
I really like your t-shirt, honey. Y'all need Jesus.
Y'all do need Jesus. Thank you.
So do I. Need Jesus. Okay, the second one is gifts. Giving thoughtful gifts to show you are thinking about someone.
Here is this copy of the five love languages from Gary Chapman. I think you should read it.
Are you saying something about our marriage?
No, it's the only gift I have to give right now.
But an example of this, my favorite gift that he gives to me is a whatchamacallit bar. Sometimes he thinks about me and he just brings me one because he knows it's my favorite. And that makes me feel really special.
The third love language is acts of service. That's doing something you know the other person would like. It could be simply mowing the lawn, making your bed, your side of the bed in the morning, putting your clothes away, doing the dishes. You name it.
Okay, ladies, this is a hard one. Honey, you can control the remote.
Yeah, says no wife ever to their husband. Never. That never happened.
Okay.
The only time it happens in our house is if she's leaving the house.
True. But I watch football.
That is a plus.
Yes. Okay. The next one is quality time. Giving your undivided attention. So let's go for a bike ride, honey. Just you and me.
Or we could just make videos.
Right. Like this.
The last one, the fifth one, if you're counting at home, is physical touching. It's holding hands, it's hugging, it's kissing. Any type of physical touching that is affirming of your love between husband and wife.
Aww. Aww. So, what do you think you are?
I would say I typically lean toward quality time or gifts. It can vary on the day, but usually those two. The rest, they don't really speak to me. What about you?
Well, mine is definitely probably the gift one, but like I like little things. You know, we talk about it, and you know that like if you brought me diamonds and stuff, that like I would be like scared to wear them. Like you very rarely see me wear my wedding ring because I'm afraid to lose it. I'm gardening and crafting and all kinds of stuff. Before that, I was raising kids and chasing them in the mud, so I'm afraid to wear it. So he knows little gifts are kind of the things, unless they're like trips to Disney World. I'll take those. Yeah.
That's almost more expensive than a diamond ring.
So, and then my second is I like words of affirmation. I like to dress nice for my husband, and I like to know that he sees that. So I like to hear him say that I look nice that day.
She does look nice today. So many couples really love each other, but they don't always communicate their love for each other in a way that their partner, their spouse, could understand.
So in the first John verses we read today, it makes it clear that God wants us to love like he does. He wants us to love like he loves us, which seems really hard.
Yeah, it's impossible, honestly, outside of Christ, right? We can't love the way we're supposed to outside of our faith in Christ. And even with our faith in Christ, this side of eternity, we don't do it perfectly. That's what forgiveness and repentance are for. We're going to get to that in a few few days from now. But the Apostle John writes that God's love can find its full expression in us.
Isn't that amazing?
It is. It's absolutely amazing that through Christ, God's love is completely expressed in us.
Our marriages are a completion of God's love. Mm-hmm. How special to think of your marriage like that.
So, I want to find out how your loved one feels. That love is an important step to expressing your love affectionately. So, try to figure out which maybe of the five love languages you each speak and then use that to talk to one another.
I think in this book, oh yeah, there is.
There's a quiz.
There's like a whole quiz in this book. Like if you get the book, there's a whole quiz in there to help you figure out what your love language is. Or you could just talk.
All right, yes.
A lot of talking.
Yep. And so with that, we enter devotion with prayer.
Father, help me to be a student of my spouse.
I want to know how best to show my love.
Please give me wisdom as I try to determine my beloved's love language.
Amen.
Amen.
Once again, we thank you for joining us, and we will see you again real soon.
We'll see you later.